Back again with another TV crew story, Dave Firestone. And again, this one's taking place in 98. Like, we had just a lot of weird crap happen to us in 98. But this is one of the funnier stories we had. It wasn't funny at the time, but in retrospect, it's hilarious. So our school had three separate auditoriums. Our high school had three separate auditoriums. You had the main large one in the art wing, which wasn't designed to hold every... Well, it was probably designed... It was probably, at the time it was made, designed to hold every student, but there was no way it could hold every student. It was just a large auditorium for concerts, the musicals, and that stuff. We had a second tiny auditorium, which is located directly adjacent to the main auditorium. That one was just for... the freshman play went on there. There were a few things that took place in that one. So it did get used, albeit not as much as the other two. And then there was sort of the main one for plays, which was the upstairs theater, because it was located on the third floor. So we would film all the plays, and we hated doing them because it was just a pain in the ass to do with the way it was set up. In order to get the equipment to where this auditorium was, we had to go to the loading dock. We had to get on the freight elevator, go up three floors, and the freight elevator opened in the wood shop of the theater where all the sets were made, so we would just set up our stuff there. So we had to set our cameras up on these two platforms, which were not the most structurally sound places on earth. In fact, I actually refused to be a cameraman for any play because these things would shake unmercifully. So there was always a couple of plays. There was a staff play, but the big one that took place in the upstairs theater was the school variety show. It's basically like a bunch of different comedy sketches, musical numbers. It was actually the most fun of the plays that we did, even though it was a pain in the ass to do. Well, we had one particular shoot for that particular setup. And what our staff leader would do was he would go and he would watch the show like the week before. He would write notes so we'd know what to do. You know, we want to make sure that we got the cameras in the right place. And it just was what it was. But this particular incident, it was not even a third of the way through because we hadn't even gotten to the first intermission yet. One of the sketches, they decided to, for reasons that escape me, I don't know who thought this was a good idea, they decided to have pyro. Like, I think it was something about the devil, and the devil would come out to two small explosions. Now, I'm not a theater expert, but if you're going to have a show in a relatively small auditorium, pyrotechnics are a no-no. Because, as we found out, they set off the fire alarm. So we had spent like 45 minutes getting everything set up. We're not even a third of the way through, and the fire alarm goes off. And I'm literally looking around, and we're all looking at each other like, what the hell is this? And there was no like motivation to leave that quickly. Because again, we knew that the school wasn't burning down. It was just a pyrotechnic setup that, you know, ba-boom, ba-boom. And set off the fire alarm. So we were lollygagging. We had to shut everything down. And we evacuate. So because this wasn't a planned thing that was done by the school, wasn't a fire drill or anything, the fire department has to show up and reset the alarm from as we understood it. So we had to wait in the parking lot for the fire department to show up. And it took them a while, But after what I think was like at least 20 or 30 minutes. So after that happened, we were finally able to go back up and we filmed the rest of the show. And we're like, okay, thank God that's over. And we go to review the tape of the play we had just filmed. And at some point during the evacuation, a cable had gotten disconnected. So while it looked as though we were producing the show, in fact, we weren't recording anything. And that was just, are you kidding me? So I'd committed to something the next day, so I couldn't be there for that phone. But from what I heard in the aftermath, the people who didn't learn their lesson because they did the same thing with the exact same results the next night. Again, it's not a large auditorium. It's not meant for pyrotechnics. How about not setting off the pyrotechnics? But yeah, that's the sort of thing, that's the sort of idiocy that we dealt with. And realistically, if you had just had the devil come out to red lights, that would have worked perfectly too. You didn't need to completely derail the play midway through. Yeah, but it's just stupidity. Well, yeah, I do have a few more stories that I'm probably going to save for a future day, because I've got like three other projects I'm gonna be working on. So I'll get to them at some point, but I will get to them. But I'm Dave Firestone. See you next time.